Okay, people, we're back for this day one of the main event Legacy, and we have two players. One of them is Yuan. I don't know which side. I'm gonna check that out. Anyway, that's the Legacy main event, and if you were there earlier at the beginning of the stream, you could see that there was a big news, as there will be a second BOM this year in Paris, 1st, 2nd and 3rd of November. Okay, so it begins with the turn one. Duras and the player one, as I don't know his name, takes a look at Yuan's hand with the ponder, force of will, third size. It's a creeping tar pit, academy rune, fetch. And a swamp. Alors je sais pas si vous m'entendez sur le stream, si vous m'entendez, vous pouvez me le dire. Donc il décide de sortir la faux et fait un LED. Ok. Size Burning Wish. Burning Wish and Ponder. Yuan goes down at 18. Je fais que Steph, ok. Alors, je vais mettre Steph, c'est Stéphanie, c'est ça? Ok. Hop, et nickel, merci. Donc apparemment l'adversaire de Yuan est une fille. Je sais pas. Stéphanie peut-être, c'est Steph. Ouais, chaque année il joue Esper Blade, j'ai l'impression. Et son adversaire ne fait rien. Un LED égo. J'ai oublié de compter, pourquoi il est revenu à 18. Il est censé être à 17 Yuan normalement. Puisqu'il a pris un point de fetch et 2 points de top size. Une Liliana, et bah écoute, ça m'a l'air plutôt correct. Ouais bah ouais, tu peux effectivement. C'est une bonne décision, remballer sur Liliana. C'était assez rapide et ça fait 1-0 pour Yuan du Denon. On va directement pouvoir passer à la vitesse éclair à la game numéro 2. Ça change un petit peu des rythmes de game d'hier. If you want to check out the games of the standard PTQ for Dublin that happened on Wednesday in Nancy, then you can check all the videos on the Watch the Match YouTube channel, or
YouTube.
Only YouTube?
No, Facebook.
Or you can go directly on our Facebook page and click on the YouTube panel. So yeah, basically that was a pretty weird game, yeah, the first game. I guess the Stephanie or Steph plays ANT, and she didn't have like an opportunity to do anything, and it was pretty fast. And Liliana for the win, of course. Apparemment Yohan essaie de nous montrer son side, mais j'arrive pas à voir. Mais c'est cool. C'est bien qu'il prenne l'initiative. Okay, sorry for the small cut. Guys, we're back in the game. And it's a Gitaxian probe for Steph on Yuan's hand. So he has Inquisition of Kozilek, Cabal Therapy, Snapcaster, Sofaf, and the Stoneforge Mystic. It's a pretty good hand. What is she going to remove? Oui, c'est Ant. Oh, she didn't remove anything. She could have tried at least. C'est un move en effet qui se tente de retirer une carte sur Gitaxian Probe. Ça s'est vu, ça s'est réussi plusieurs fois d'ailleurs. Un pondé. Ponder. Un reshuffle.
Vous pouvez désormais appeler un arbitre pour acter que vous avez gagné la partie. If you still not have any opponent, please call a judge to confirm that you just won the game.
A priori, Johan va fetcher sur un land à base de noir pour faire son inquisition. Ça m'a l'air pas mal. Alors, messe noire, Burning Wish, Silence, Pétale. Infernal Tutor et Lotus Petal. Donc, Johan, who is actually, for those of you who don't know him, he's actually a French national champion in Yu-Gi-Oh! And he stopped playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Because now he's more than 16 years old and started playing Magic the Gathering. Yep, as he has like another, he has Cabal Therapy in hand, so it will be pretty hard for the ANT player to win the game, I think. But you don't know.